Hello friends, welcome to Bankers Platform. So friends, in today's session, we will discuss Interest Equalization Scheme on pre and post shipment rupee export credit extension. So friends, this is a circular, which is the latest circular, and it is published on 8th March 2022 on RBI website, and it is published by RBI. So friends, this is related to interest equalization. So friends, interest equalization scheme is there for pre and post shipment rupee export credit. So friends, jitne bhi hamare exporters hain, unhe jo hai interest equalization scheme se benefit milta hai on pre and post shipment. So there was a validity. Friends, earlier this scheme was only valid up to 1st October. This scheme was only valid up to 1st October, but now they have made this extension in this circular. So let's see, this is the 1st October. Earlier this scheme was valid up to 1st October 2021, and now they have made the extension from 1st October 2021. It will be with effect from 1st October 2021. So let's see what are the important points of this circular. As friends, this circular will be very important for bank promotion exam. So let's see. Government of India has approved the extension of interest equalization scheme for pre and post shipment rupee export credit scheme up to 31st March 2024. So friends, now this scheme will be up to 31st March 2024. So this point is very important. This can be asked in the coming bank promotion exam. So you can remember this thing, 31st March 2024. So this will be valid up to this time or till further review, whichever is earlier. So friends, like if RBI is making any meeting, agar RBI koi review karta hai, to ye jo date hai wo change bhi ho sakti hai, but for the time being you have to remember 31st March 2024. So this will be valid up to 31st March 2024, and it will be from effect of 1st October 2021 and ends on 31st March 2024. So friends, kya modifications hai? Let's see. So first, there will be telecoms instrument sector having 6 lines shall be out of the preview of the scheme except for MSME manufacturer exporter. So friends, ye jo telecom sector hai, telecom instrument sector jo hai, wo isse out hai for this scheme, or this scheme will be for MSME manufacturer exporters. So in ke liye ye scheme hai. So what are the changes? Revised interest rate, interest equalization rate under the scheme will be now 3%. So friends, ab jo hai 3% ka interest subvention milega MSME manufacturer exporters ko, and exporting under any HS line. So HS line is harmonized system codes are there for different products. So any line, wo kisi bhi line mein ho, उन्हें 3% का इंटरेस्ट सबवेंशन मिलेगा, इक्वलाइजेशन, एंड दिस विल नॉट बी फॉर टेलीकॉम इंस्ट्रूमेंट, एंड 2% फॉर मैन्युफैक्चरर एक्सपोर्टर एंड मर्चेंट एक्सपोर्टर, और 2% होगा मैन्युफैक्चरर एक्सपोर्टर्स के लिए और मर्चेंट. एमएसएमई मैन्युफैक्चरर अगर फ्रेंड्स, तो 3%, एंड इट्स इफ दैट पर्सन इज ओनली मैन्युफैक्चरर एक्सपोर्टर एंड मर्चेंट एक्सपोर्टर, देन 2%, एंड आफ्टर एक्सक्लूडिंग दिस टेलीकॉम सेक्टर. ओके, so this you have to remember. Next is, banks while issuing approval to the exporter will necessarily furnish first the prevailing interest rate. So friends, agar bank jo hai ye details RBI ko de raha hai, to use pehla batana hoga what is the prevailing interest rate is charged by the bank and the interest subvention being provided, aur kitna interest subvention usko provide kiya gaya, and the net rate being charged to the each exporter. So net rate kitna charge kiya ja raha hai, that they have to mention. Okay, so as to ensure transparency and greater accountability in the operation of scheme. So next point is, for the period 1st October 21 to 31st March 2022, bank shall identify the eligible exporter as per scheme, credit their account with eligible amount of interest equalization, and submit sector-wise consolidated reimbursement claim for the said period to the Reserve Bank by 30 April 2022. तो जितने भी इंटरेस्ट इक्वलाइजेशन के लिए इलिजिबल हैं, जितने भी अकाउंट्स, उनकी जो रिपोर्ट है, दैट बैंक्स दे हैव टू प्रोवाइड बाय 30 April 2022 फॉर द पीरियड 1st October 21 to 31st March 2022 विद इफेक्ट फ्रॉम 1st April 2022. bank shall reduce the interest rate charged to the eligible exporter upfront. So friends, ye point aapko yaad rakhna hai. Pehle jo hum interest equalization mein kya hota tha, like bank jo hai wo apna interest charge karte the aur uske baad jo hai unhe reimbursement type mein, like jaisa ki yahan pe aap dekh rahe ho, bank has to provide the detail. So reserve bank would give them back the difference amount jo bhi unka claim hota tha, that they give. But ab jo hai RBI ne ise interest rate ko upfront dene ke liye banks ko instruct kiya, and submit their claim original within 15 days. Like bank ne upfront jo hai discount de diya jo bhi hai, like interest subvention ka, to the customer, and after that bank they have to claim in original within 15 days. So bank ko jo hai within 15 days from the end of the respective month, with bank seal and signed by authorized person in the prescribed format. So friends, ek format hai, in that format that bank they have to apply for claim for the interest seven, this interest equalization, jo bhi 2% ka ya like 3%, whatever the amount is there as per the customer eligibility. So they have to send the claim within 15 days. Like if in March it is up to 31st, after March they have to give within 15 days, means 15 days means 15th of April. Before that they have to claim for the March. So this is the new change in this. Okay, so friends, other provision of the exempt is extant instruction issued by the bank on the caption scheme shall remain unchanged. So jo baki jo bhi provisions hai wo waise rahenge. Okay, so this is the friend annexure. This is an annexure that banks they have to submit total amount of interest equalization reimbursement claim, amount of interest equalization reimbursement claim in respect of beneficiary belong to SC, ST, Northeastern region. So friends, this sector, like which sector that person is. So this is the annexure format for the claim. So, and this point you have to remember that these three points are very important. In we also certify while issuing approval to the exporter, we have furnished prevailing interest rate, interest subvention being provided, and the net rate being charged to each borrower. So this is the format. So friends, is circular mein aap ye points yaad rakh sakte hain. First point will be, this will be valid up to 31st March 2024 or till further review. Okay, one point, an extension jo hai wo kab se effected hai, that is 1st October 2021. Aur jo telecom instrument sector hai, that is out of this thing. And 3% will be for MSME manufacturer exporter. Okay, and 2% for manufacturer exporter and merchant exporter. So these are the main points, and these three points that I already told. And one more thing is there, the extended scheme will not be available to those beneficiary who are availing the benefit under any PLI scheme, production link incentive. Agar friends, koi bhi customer hai jo already PLI scheme ka benefit le raha hai, they will not get any benefit under this scheme, is in this interest equalization scheme. Okay, so these are the main points that you have to remember. So thank you friends, thanks for watching. I hope so this video is beneficial for you. So friends, if you're benefited from this video, you can like this video and share this video with your friends who are preparing for bank promotion exam and also in banks. This is also for information purpose. Thank you friends, have a nice day.